We've had some good songs, and I've enjoyed them, and I've enjoyed the presence of being here this morning, and God's presence of being here in the house this morning. We can leave now and go to the house and say that it was good to be in God's house this morning. I've enjoyed it. I heard some good songs, some good testimony, and I really enjoy it, Brother Bill. But I appreciate our mothers this morning, and happy Mother's Day to y'all again. But if you got your Bibles, turn over to the book of Proverbs. Book of Proverbs, chapter 31. 31. I'm just going to read a verse here and get right on into the message. I'm going to read one verse. And sometimes today or now, I want you to finish reading this chapter from 10 through 31. And it's all about the mothers and what a mother's supposed to be. In verse 10, who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. Precious Lord, I love you this morning. I thank you, God, again for this lovely day. Thank you for this opportunity to give you thanks, God. Father, this day has been set aside to recognize our mothers, precious Lord. Father, I ask you to bless them today and to meet their needs, precious Lord. Father, I ask you to this morning, God, to be the being that's on our prayer list, Lord. You know the needs this morning, and I ask you to meet those needs, Father, too, according to your will, Lord. Lord, I ask you to use me one more time. God, I want you to have the glory and the praise of you and your Son, Lord. I can't do nothing without you, Father. I ask for your guidance. I'm asking you the words this morning, Father. In Jesus' precious, lovely name, Father, I ask. And I do thank you, God. Amen. I ain't going to hold you up for just a few minutes here. This morning there, and it said, who can find a virtuous woman there? What does this woman mean? How a lady in the house, how a mother is supposed to be. Brothers and sisters, today we've all had mothers. We can reach back and think about how our mothers taught us, how our mothers taken care of us. Brothers and sisters, today, if it hadn't been for my mama taking care of me and our family, we wouldn't be here today. And if it wasn't for the mothers standing up and being a church member a lot of time, the fathers would not be getting it to us, because their work was from sun up to sun down. And the old saying is, theirs was from sun up to sun down, but the mother's work was never ended. Her work never went out. The candle never stopped burning in the mama's house. Brothers and sisters, I remember when I was a boy, it'd be cold, Brother Phil. We would get up in the morning time, but the breakfast would be ready, and it'd be sitting on the table. You could smell the groceries cooking, and mama had done been up. Mama had done built the fire. Groceries was ready. She was calling us to come and eat. Brothers and sisters, let me tell you one thing. If it wasn't for mamas today, we wouldn't be in places that we are now, because the fathers wouldn't stand up sometime for what was right.
Amen.
The fathers work. Mama's work had never ended. Mama, you always went to mama. If you stomped your toe, you had a headache or something, you went to mama. Daddy never did know what was going on, but mama knew. She would get up in the morning time and put the apron on. And the last thing that I seen that night when I'd go to bed was her apron was still on, because her work was never done. Amen. She provided for her family. She put her family first, Sister Dolly, ahead of everything else. She wanted to make sure her family was taken care of. Her husband would come in during the day. When my daddy get there, it'd be dark most of the time. Supper would be ready. He would eat. Let me tell you what. And we'd all leave the table. Sometimes the oldest one would probably help Mama in the kitchen. And that would be Lee, my sister and Larry's sister. She would help in the kitchen clean up. We would go to bed. Because Daddy believed in one light burning and he was sitting under it. And you went to bed. The other word that he had, the chickens flying up, you better be headed that way. Amen. Anyhow, we would go to bed. And late at night, Sister Dolly, this is how our mothers would check on us. It'd be late at night and you'd hear the door squeak open, you know. And here she is, she opens the door and she looks in to see what we're doing. See if we're covered up right. And if you didn't have the blanket on you and it was cold, she would tuck you in. But she was checking on her children. Brothers and sisters, today, that's the way our Heavenly Father is today. He checks on us all the time. We can't get out of His sight. We're in His sight 24 hours a day. He's watching over us and He's providing for us. Same way a mama would provide. She patched her clothes, Brother Rudy. She always in life intended. We were poor folks. But let me tell you what, there was always food on the table. She was going to make sure that we had food to eat. Every once in a while, a chicken would get killed. We'd have fried chicken. You know what Mama would do? She'd reach over in the plate and get that back. And the last part that went over the fence. That was hers. Because she wanted her children to have her best.
Yes.
That's what Mama was putting forward. I learned a lot from my mama. Because they wanted their children to have the best.
Yes.
We can't do without our mama. I went out yesterday and seen some mamas that was in bad shape. It broke my heart to see them like that. And these men sitting there with their wives in that shape. I know what they're going through, those men. Praise God that they'll kill us straight. I can't go down that road, Father. It's one that they have to do. And there's a lot of us that went down that river for our lives. Someone that was a mama. Not our children. I love my children. And my wife always called her mama ever since when the first one come along. And it's all of it called her mama. She was good to our children. I went out to Mama. My mom was 73 years old. With flowers on hers. I met a man coming out of there. He didn't know who I was. I said, I met you. I told him who he was. And he just dragged me and hugged me. He said, Brother Harry. He said, do we ever quit missing our moms? I said, no, son. I said, they're special. Very special. I said, that's the closest one to you. She's the one that has told you 9 months before you were born. She's the one that's cared for us to get us up there when we walk away. One is always nursing us, watching over us. I said, no, we'll always remember our moms. I said, God wants us to remember our moms. because they are, have a special place in God's heart. Let me tell you, they do, Brother Rupert. They really do. Because see, one day God looked down. He said, I need to go down yonder and save my people. He said, I'm going to ask you a question. He chose to believe. And Jesus was born a virgin.
Yes.
Today, if God was to look down to find a godly woman, could he find one? Could he find one? I'm very sure. Because we still got some good ones today. We got some good mamas. Now we got some mamas that have the children, but they're not no mamas. You know, that breaks my heart. That breaks my heart. I just heard the other day there's over 600,000 babies aborted every year. Now that ought to break your heart. It breaks God's heart. There's women out here today that would love to have one of those young men. But no, somebody's going to pay for that one day. Call it what you want to. It's murder.
Amen.
It's murder. There's no way around it. No, they can let them buy it. But thank God, God said all the judgments turned over to Jesus. That person's going to stand one day, Brother Bill. He's going to pay for that. Let me tell you something else. You see, when God created Adam and Eve, he put Adam in the garden. Adam was only a half of a man. Only a half of a man. What do you mean? A half of a man is all there was. And then what happened? God created the woman. Help me. You hear me, men? A helpmate. And they was joined together and became one. He became a full man because he had his partner. Had his helpmate. There's a lot of our women and girls that have been misabused. God didn't intend for that. That's our helpmate. They're supposed to help in their home. They're providers. Look at the providers. I never did know what a checkbook was or nothing. When I got married, all that turned over to my wife. I didn't know what was in my room. If I asked her, I could sit down with her. Supposed to take care of my providers. We can't do it without our mom. You see? And Jesus come along. He had a mom. My Savior was born that way. That's the reason God gave us that special place to die in His heart and mom. Because you see, they're doing exactly what God said. It proved. I love all of you moms. I appreciate you. Every effort that you do. I'll tell you something else. God appreciates everything that you've done. It's all wrote down in your book. All the good that you take care of. How you?
Sit down.
Will never stop missing you. But one day, Sister Carol, she said, I'll be with her. And then Brother Bill says, forever. There ain't gonna be no separation. One big thing. Worshiping God. And ladies, if you have a mother, children, today when you get home, call them. If you go see them, don't see them.
That's right.
Look at their name.
Anybody have any special need or anything this morning? Just stand and I'll go ahead and just listen.